The last movie combines the previous two 1D examples into a two-dimensional example. Here, the lower left paramedian paddle shows a 2D model of a face slice to be imaged, representing as a 6x6 array of grayscale densities. The top middle panel shows a corresponding 6x6 array of red arrows representing the transverse components of the net magnetization, or spins, within each voxel. Again, the left-hand panel shows multiple timelines, the top showing the RF power for the 90-degree and 80-degree spin flips, the next showing the Z gradient for slice selection, the next showing the Y gradient for phase encoding, the next showing the X gradient for frequency encoding, and the next showing the time window of signal acquisition, and finally the bottom showing the continuous signal received. As before, each time course, the acquired signal is Fourier transformed and graphed in the right-hand panel. Note how there are now 6 peaks, each representing the total signal received from an entire column. Now it only remains to sort out the signal from within each column. The sequence is again repeated another 5 times for a total of 6 cycles, once for each row of the image. Each time there's a different amount of phase encoding, which is a known quantity. At the end, there's enough information to solve for spins within each column. The image is thereby inverted and displayed in the lower right paramedian panel next to the initial image. In reality, the order of the mathematical steps taken in the scanner's computer is different than the one presented here, involving a two-dimensional Fourier transform after the formation of a two-dimensional K-space. Abstractly, the mathematics is symmetrically two-dimensional, but deep down, although the ordering is different, the final mathematical result is identical, and this method presented here is to provide an intuition about why n scans are needed for n lines.